Well, hello and a very warm welcome to the Taekwondo venue here at Nanjing International Expo Centre, the host for our Olympic Taekwondo. This is the second Summer Youth Olympic Games. How are you? I hope you're well, wherever you're joining us from. A great chance to share this wonderful sporting spectacle. 58 nations gathered, 100 athletes, evenly divided, 50 female, 50 male. Two categories for you to enjoy tonight. The minus 49 kilogram female semi-finals coming up, and the men's 55 semi-finals likewise. And then, of course, down to the big business at the end of the day, gold medal time. Who will be crowned the Youth Olympic champion? Well, you will get to enjoy it along with us. There's some cracking matches of the 58 nations that we mentioned. Into a possible eight now to decide the destination of the gold, silver and the two bronze medals as well. In the 49 kilogram females, well, you can expect speed, agility and flexibility, and the same with the men in the 55s, and add into that some power as well. So plenty to look forward to. If you're an expert in the sport, you probably know the rules. And if you're new to it, well, there's plenty of time for us to get acquainted with them, and we'll do that step by step, kick by kick. We've maybe got friends or family that are competing today. Best of luck to them. And of course, plenty of local interest as well. The countries involved. Two athletes from Chinese Taipei, which will get a lovely ovation, I'm sure. They'll save the big applause for the local favourite from China, Zhang Chaoru. But our first match for your entertainment will be the 49 kilogram, the first semi-final, Mexico against Taipei. Mitzi Yamena Carrillo Osorio, she's in blue, and she goes against Chinese Taipei's Wang Hu Xian. In the taekwondo we have three corner judges and one centre referee. The corner judges are in charge of scoring the punches and the head kicks. The centre referee is in charge of the safety and indeed the flow of the game. You can just see in the back of your screen there, just in the top left, coming in past the scoreboards. The athletes are on their way. Presiding over the action, Iva Romanov of Croatia, and her judging panel was the Fab Female Four, Fatem Dridi of Tunisia, her compatriot from Thailand, Sudi Kayala. And Annabelle Capual of Côte d'Ivoire. Dennis Kojo, the video referee. Well, the officials are in position. The athletes are ready to go. Carrillo Osorio of Mexico, all the way from the Yucatan province. And a lovely smile there. Huang Hyun-Soo from Taipei City. She is the Asian Games junior champion. Quite a step up here to the Youth Olympic Games. This is for a spot in the final. Well, this is the women's minus 49 kilogram semi-final here at the Nanjing Youth Olympic Games. Round number one, Mexico in blue, Chinese Taipei in red. Carrillo Osorio of Mexico, the shorter of the two, some 5 inches in height. And Huang Xiaotu trying to use the front leg, hooks up to the face, wonderful head kick there from the Chinese Taipei fighter. The front leg is the leg closest to the opponent. And you can guess which one the back leg is then. Both ladies now in an open stance. That means the same foot in front. Trying to draw the opponent in, giving them a big target. Huang, the dominant of the two, just standing her ground. She's taking centre stage. Can she take a further lead? She can indeed. A perfect push kick. Mitzi Yamena Carrillo Osorio of Mexico. Gonna have to try and change her strategy. Well, she changes her stance. But Huang, with a fearsome cry, maintains that 4-0 lead. The Mexican's gone into her shell just a little bit of trepidation. She doesn't want to make too many more mistakes. Covering that head there, using the hands to block the kick. Faking and testing, trying to draw a response. Well, as first rounds go, Wang Qianxian of Chinese Taipei. Very, very composed. Let's have a look at the scoring shots. There's the push kick to the body. And the hook kick to the face. And if you're new to the sport, you'll realise that obviously they're wearing head guards and chest guards. They have to wear a mouth guard as well. And indeed the gloves. Last minute bits of advice from Julio Lozario, the Mexican coach. Lin Wang, Chinese Taipei, likewise giving his charge some advice. Here we go, round two. The women's 49 kilogram semi-final match. Mexico in blue, Chinese Taipei in red. And it is Taipei's Wang Jiaosu that's in the lead at the moment. Looking good value for it. Carrillo Osorio of Mexico. She's having to defend herself. Using her hands to block the kicks. She's under the art of kicking and punching. And the master at the moment is in the middle. Good work again for Huang from Taipei. Good power. Change of stance from Osorio, opening it up, trying to use the front leg to hook it in. And again, it's a lovely, simple technique. A perfectly placed push kick produces another point for Huang. All nerves will be gone now for both fighters. They're settling into the rhythm now, got their distance. Osorio just coming up a little bit short. She's only 5'2". Huang, 5'7". And that length differential is helping the Taiwanese fighter at the moment, just using that front leg to great effect. One more time. Not scoring. But destabilizing and demotivating Osorio. Good cover there though from the Mexican, using her hands just to block the kicks. Well, it's more of the same from Huang, all the way from Taipei City. The Asian Games junior champion. She'd love to add the Youth Olympic Games title to that career.
Ahora sí quiero.
Julio Alejandro Lizanzo, the Mexican coach, saying you can kick to the face, you've got to get closer. Huang Huang Sin dreams of being a police officer. That would be her ideal career. She wants to be committing crimes around Taipei City. She's the officer in charge. But the lady in charge in the middle, Eva Romanov of Croatia, calls those fighters to attention. We're away in the third and final round of this female 49 kilogram semi-final match. And it's heating up nicely. Good contest. Osorio just about avoiding their good cover. Good head kick attempt from Huang, but a good body shot from Carillo Osorio. The young Mexican from the Yucatan province. Our sports hero is Maria Espinosa, the Mexican Olympic champion in Taekwondo. Could she become the youth Olympic champion? There's one big reason why not, and it stands in the form of Frank Janssen. She's looking very composed and very strong. Kyungo, the first one of the match. And Carillo Osorio produced something. He walks onto the front leg. Attempted reverse turning kick from the young Mexican. Spins, but slips. Takes a Kyungo, which makes it now 6-1. And with just over 30 seconds left, you can't see any way back now for Osorio of Mexico. Huang Helsun. She's looking good, very strong indeed. Doesn't have to attack, can just stand on the defence now. Run the clock down. Takes great concentration and strength to do that. Osorio trying with the spin. She's not gone down without a fight. She's tried to produce something here. A great defensive strength from Huang. She knows that there is a spot in the Youth Games Olympic final for her. And on she goes. Much to the delight of the local crowd. Of course, Chinese Taipei getting some great support. A chance now to go to the final. To her obvious delight. Nice work from the Mexican coach there, just tying the body armor for her. But it's Huang Jiansu. She will be into the final. Mitzi Yamena Carillo Osorio. And she's been fighting hard and she's won a wonderful bronze medal, richly deserved. Current disappointment for Mitzi Yamena Carillo Osorio, but with perspective she will be happy with a brilliant bronze medal. Huang Jiansen of Chinese Taipei. She will be in the final by virtue of these wonderful scoring kicks. The hook kick there to the body. Fantastic to see. Well, who will meet her in the final? Well, we have a potential classic Chinese cracker here. We have Zhang Chanrel or Belgium's Indra Krayen. Could it be Chinese Teapot Taipei against China in the final? What a match that would be. But Indra Krayen will have plenty to say about that. Just to let you know, the referees are just getting ready. So 2 minutes until the action recommences. Chinese crowd more than delighted with the spectacle of the taekwondo so far, and there's even more entertainment for them because we now have an athlete in the minus 49 kilogram category, the female semi-final from China, Jian Chan Ru. She will go against Belgium's Indra Kryan.
Yes.
Who will get the most support in the Nanjing International Expo Arena? Let's have a little listen as the athletes are announced. Well, big moments for these young ladies. And making sure that everything runs smoothly. The referees and judges in place, in position. Center referee from Puerto Rico, Elizabeth Tavares, from Australia, Mohamed Magablet, from Korea we have Che Young Hwan, and all the way from Greece, Maria Mercuria.
Review jury from Vietnam,
Mr. Vu Jan Tan. From Vietnam, he's in charge of the video replay system.
Athlete in blue, representing People's Republic Korea, China.
Jian Tian Ru. A popular youngster from the Yunnan province of China. Two times national champion, Indra Kryan from Belgium. From Beth Verlanden from Belgium. She looks happy, she looks ready to go.
Let's do it.
Let's do it indeed. Karim Dagugi, the coach. And Karim Dagugi called back into action again. The body armour just a little bit loose. Good work from the cameraman there, sliding around. You can see they're tied up at the back. And if they're not tied tightly enough, then the impact is lessened and the point is less likely to score. So they're all tied up and ready to go. This, of course, the semi-final of the women's 49 kilogram category. Jian of China, she's in blue. From Belgium, Indra Kryan. In red, and Jian straight away trying with the head kick. Very composed fighter. Good mover as well. Indra Kryan though, from Brussels. She's got the muscles to battle the way through here. She fought her way to this semi-final position. Good cover as well from the young Belgian. Picks her hand up just to ward off the attempts of Jian. Good attempted back leg turning kick from Indra Kryan. Almost connecting with the body protector there. The sensor socks from Indra Kryan have connected. See the little white socks on the fighter's feet. When they marry up with good contact and good impact to the body, then 1 point will score. Kyungo. That's an admonishment for falling over. If you get two Kyungos, then it's a point added. Getting closer to the head, but that Kyungo again evens it up, as we said. But Jeanne not having it all her own way. She's a very confident fighter. Trying some clever little work on the inside. Good back kick though from Jeanne. Back kicks worth 2 points by virtue of their difficulty. Double your money for the difficulty. Ninja Crying trying to stay in this first round. Fantastic first round from both female 49 kilogram fighters. Jian Tian Ru 3-1 to the good by virtue of a brilliant back kick. Let's have a look at it. Turns her back, places her foot on the body. They're a 2 point shot because they're doubly difficult. Perfect view for you there. Yeah. Crying, well involved in this. Karim Degui, the coach, trying to encourage his fighter. Lu Fan, the Chinese coach, has the easier job. 2 point gap so far. China against Belgium. This is the 49 kilogram semi-final second round match. China in blue grabbing a 4-1 lead against Belgium's Indra Krayen. It's a good shot from Krayen though on the inside again. She's working very well at the close distance. Good push kick attempt from Huang. It was a perfect example of Taekwondo's flexibility. Reaches upstairs. Six 2 now in favour of Huang. Jeanne Rel. Good back leg turning kick. Attempt from Indra Krayen. Just over a minute left in this second round. Indra Krayen of Belgium in blue, or in red, excuse me. Gonna have to try and change her tactics a little bit. She's getting closer on the inside with these short turning kicks. And Huang Hiao Xian, she knows she's in a match here. Just 4 points separating them. Good power from the Belgian. Good double turning kick from Huang. And there's the back kick that we've come to know from her. Kyungo for holding against the Chinese fighter. Good work from Krayen. Gets herself back in. Well, a promising end to the round for the young Belgian. That was the back kicks. Jian Tian Ru, that's why she's 6-3 to the good. Lu Fan, happy with the work. Karim Degui, the coach, reminding his fighter to put everything into this. She's worked hard. Here's the back kick. Technically, very, very sound fighter. Lovely shot. There's Wu Jingyu, Olympic champion from 2008, looking on at the potential youth Olympic champion for 2014. It's of course the semi-final of the female 49 kilogram category. Indra Krayen from Belgium in red. China, Jian Chan Ru, just too good at the moment. Very aggressive start to the round. Jian trying with the front leg tunnel kick twice there, doesn't score. Good effort. Wow, wonderful headshot there. Almost scoring, but Indra Krayen sneaks one underneath the guard. She's finding her way back into this now. Jan has to fight for this. And of course, shots of Jai Yo coming thick and fast. Go for it. Maria Miraklou of Greece has noticed that the body protector has come loose. Ryan's working hard, as is Jian. Jian Tran Ru, what can she do? Less than a minute left. Jian's going to have to watch because she's got some kungos against her name. Let Jai Yo go for it. A cry from the passionate local crowd here. Indra Krayen working on it. A good headshot though from Jian. Scores a perfect one and a step through reverse turning kick at the same time. Well, Karim Dugu. Karim Dugu is asking for a kick after Kallio. Now Kallio means to stop. So if the Chinese fighter kicked after Kallio, it would be one full point deduction. So when the referee says stop, you have to stop. And the Belgian coach is contending that after this moment here, this is not the contentious point. The contentious point is had the referee stopped the action at that point. More in hope than expectation, I would imagine. But what a throw of the dice. Van Tien Thu from Vietnam. He's the man on the front of your screen there with Thomas Bossom in the middle. Is it successful? It is successful. Good work from the coach. So that will be one full point taken away from China's Jian. Very good refereeing, very good spot from the coach. Now it's quite legitimate for the Chinese coach. But the exact same conversation is happening on the other side. So the Chinese coach Lu Fan is saying that after Kallio, the Belgian athlete kicked, and her score should be at 6, not 7. Well, it's a busy old day for the video replay jury. Lu Fan quite within his rights to throw the video replay card. Now let's look at the referee's hand. As the referee steps in to stop the action here. At this point, it's 9-6. The video replay refused. Good try from Lu Fan. It's As We Were. 30 seconds left. Jan scores, but she takes a head kick there. It's 10 each. What a wonderful moment for Indra Krayan, and she scores a lovely little turning kick underneath. This is going against the local favourites, but Indra Krayan is fighting with all she has. Wonderful power, wonderful precision. And it's time for a protest. Looking for 3 points for a head kick. Indra Krayan now. Huge controversy here. This could be a big moment in the future of both these female fighters. Let's watch Krayan. Does she get anywhere near the head? She certainly thinks so. Not on this occasion, but the previous kick. That man there, Karim Dugu. Prima, be first. Go for it. And here you can see what we're looking at, just over the athlete's shoulder. Any contact from Blue on... Oh, it could be. No, Man Chan Poo says no. Well, this is Olympic Taekwondo. This is the semi-finals. 11 each between China and Belgium. China and Blue, Belgium and Red. Who will be in the final? Akyongo is hanging over both fighters. Who will go for it? Indra Krayan tries to score underneath. This pulsating action for a spot in the Youth Olympic Games final. Will there be enough time? Will they go for it? Will it go to sudden death? A step through, reverse turning kick, doesn't score. Wow. We are now into the sudden death golden point round. Whoever scores the point will be the champion. Okay. Couldn't be any more impressed with Indra Krayan if a try. Jan Chan Ru, the local favourite, fantastic fighter. She's been majestic all day. She's obviously got huge support here. Let's see what Krayan's got. Let's see what Jan's got. I'll tell you what we've all got. We have a fourth and final round. Well, here we go. This is the women's 49 kilogram semi-final contest at the Nanjing Youth Olympic Games. The first point to score will go to the final. And it's Indra Krayan of Belgium who sticks the shot to the body. Wonderful work from the young Belgian. Tremendous effort from her all the way through. Zhang Ranchu, tremendous effort indeed. Well, they've treated you, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. I hope you've enjoyed that. That was a brilliant match. Upsets the odds, upsets the locals. But in the end, a brilliant win for Indra Krayan. It will now be a bronze medal for Zhang Chan Ru. Well, this is how they match up then for the final match. Wang of Chinese Taipei, Krayan of Belgium. What a gold medal match that's going to be. And it will be bronzes for Carillo Rosario of Mexico and Jian of China. for the gold medal. Referee from Morocco, Granadi Tarik. The Romanov from Croatia. Segundo Flores, the Mexican judge. Kayala from Thailand. Completes the group. From Vietnam, well, he was very busy previously. Let's see what he's got to do in this one. This is the semi-final match now. From Belgium, Mohamed Kepi. And he will go against Ju Dong-hoon of South Korea. There's young Kepi there. From Barbara Province, near Brussels. Ju Dong-hoon from Busan, the very south of Korea. The video replay card being handed over. The semi-final of the men's 55 kilogram contest. Belgium in blue against Korea in red.
Round one.
Underway. Using the front legs from both fighters. Ju Dong-hoon from South Korea, the taller of the two, 6'2" and just 55 kilograms. Very tall fighter indeed. Mohamed Kepi not too far behind, 5'10", just 3 or 4 inches in it. Such are the margins between victory and defeat. Ju Dong-hoon from Korea almost stepping out of the ring. Good strength from Kepi. Qualified with a bronze medal to get here in the World Olympic qualifiers in Taiwan. That front leg again from Kepi, keeping his opponent at bay. A real stalemate so far. We'll take a Kyungo for falling here. You can see the shin guards that they wear underneath. Shin guard, groin guard, arm guards. All required in this full contact sport. Well, a bit of a stalemate just at the moment. No one wanting to commit too much. Ju Dong-hoon tries with a right leg turning kick. Well, was that an intentional block? Mohamed Kepi. Yes, indeed, he used his shin to block it. That will be a Kyungo. Not allowed to do that one. Kepi getting close with the head kick, though. Certainly a very aggressive start from the young Belgian. Can he sustain this tempo? Well, nothing doing on the scoreboards.
Yeah. 위에 있으니까 쟤는 이보다 돌고 나서 먼저 내리고 그 다음에 높게 들고 있으니까 그 다음에 내려야 되니까 쟤가 다음 발 연결이 나오거든. 너도 발을 낮게 차. 낮게 들어서 중단 카트를 들어. 낮게 똑같이 낮게 돼. 낮게 하다가 돌아 가봐.
양수 이의 그린 코치. Ibrahimi from Belgium. The coach in the corner. There's nothing to choose between the two. You can have game plans, you can have strategies, but at some point a fight has to happen. Both men were just taking their time there in the first round. Second round underway in this semi-final. Korea in red, Belgium in blue. The front legs working at a frenetic pace now. Joo Dong-hun's tried to step up the action here. He's the fighter in red. Mohammed Ketbi in blue. They're both standing in that open stance. The same leg in front, which means they're trying to cancel each other out, offering a very small target on the front side. And turning kick from Duhong on the inside though. Sometimes in top level sport you get people that cancel each other out, that cover up so well that no one can score, and that's certainly the case here at the moment. Both fighters pushing and pulling, but it is Korea's Joo Dong-hun that manages to produce a point. From Krang just tries to catch the Korean on the chest, doesn't work though. Good push kick though from the Belgian, and again he's getting closer with these shots. Joo Dong-hun not using any footwork, just standing on the spot. Good shot, but a Kyung-go in the execution of it. For holding the leg of the Korean on the way through. Mohammed Ketbi. Well, a real stalemate, a real dogfight this one. No one wanting to commit and make a mistake. Yang Su-yi saying that there's no axe kick, no chop kick from the Belgian, not to worry about that. The right leg is not coming, it's only the left. Oh, Team Belgium got off the sleeve for this final round. Well, the search for a Youth Olympic Games gold medal begins here. This is the semi-final, trying to push their way into the final. Korea's Joo Dong-hun, Mohammed Ketbi of Belgium, where they're opening up now. They're trying to elicit a response. Good attempted head kick from the Belgian. Tries with the front leg again. Ketbi, but he's been kept at bay by Joo Dong-hun. There's a good head kick attempt there from the Belgian. And he's asked his coach to have a video replay of that one. There was a flicking front leg. 3 points for a head kick is the request. Well, let's have a look. This is what they're looking at. Watch the front leg of the Belgian. Any contact? Could be, has to be contact with the chin. And at the moment, doesn't look like it. Let's see. The Belgian coach. Very tense stuff here. Wu Chantao. From Vietnam, the man on the right hand of your screen. Unsuccessful. A good throw of the dice, but is it the last chance now? There's still a Kyungo to play for, hanging against the Korean's name. Ju Dong-hun being a bit more aggressive. Well, it's 2 points each now. Good shot from Mohammed Ketbi. Turning kick attempt. Good attempted head kick from the Korean. Gets caught on the shoulder of Mohammed Ketbi. The final minute here of the semi-final. Who's going to take the chance? Who's going to take the spot in the final? Mohammed Ketbi trying to push. Ju Dong-hun from South Korea is going to have to try and find something as well. He's got 30 seconds left. Will it be Korea? Will it be Belgium? Who's going to the final? A lot of local support for Belgium. Overcommits there. Can't beat, but almost gets caught. Good block and good cover from Korea's Ju Dong-hun, who manages to sneak a shot in there in the final seconds. Ju Dong-hun has to stay tall, has to stay strong. Has he found a route to the final? He has indeed. In the very last seconds, Mohammed Ketbi absolutely disconsolate, but totally understandable. He had 1 foot in the final, and now with 1 foot into the body, he's out. Ju Dong-hun, he's in the final. Richly deserved in the end there. He hung on, he persevered, he found the route to victory. A bronze medal for Belgium's Mohammed Ketbi, absolutely distraught, and you can understand why. So close to the final. Such are the margins of victory and defeat, but it's Ju Dong-hun who will be in the men's 55 kilogram final.
Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, the semi-final men's taekwondo 55 kilogram is going to start soon. Let's welcome the referee and judges.
Who will decide the destiny of the gold medal? Jesus Tortosa Cabrera, junior world champion, or Huang Yan Xiao of Chinese Taipei? They will meet Chu Du Young in the final.
Okay.
So here we go. This one for the destination in the final. Jesus Tortosa Cabrera. The youngster from Madrid. Wang Juyin. Chinese Taipei. Taipei City. So here, who's the crowd's favourite? Cabrera, the Spanish coach there with the video replay card, but it's this young man standing at 6'2", really very tall, the tallest in the category. And Jacques Grogg, former IOC president, enjoying the action here. The Youth Olympic Games, of course, his brainchild. He'll be proud to watch these fighters duke it out for a spot in the final. This one, the semi-final of the men's 55 kilogram semi-final contest. Jesus Tortosa Cabrera, he's in blue. Huang Juyin of Chinese Taipei in red. Good attempted head kick from Jesus Cabrera. Good turning kick to the body from Huang. Customary feeling out process, trying to gauge the right distance, trying to choose the right kick. Good headshot there from Huang, almost scoring. Very much of a stalemate here. Nothing to choose between the two fighters. It's a goal for a spot in the final. It's a good shot there from Jesus Tortosa Cabrera. Huang Xiangjiao trying to get in amongst it himself there. Not quite managing it just yet. One of the innovations of Taekwondo, video replay now. Marco Cabrera. Mohamed Magabalev of Australia asking for a 3-point video jury review. Marco Cabrera, Spanish coach. Looking up at the big screen now to decide, will it be a successful headshot? The video replay is rejected. The card is pocketed. And we are back underway now. Jesus Tortosa Cabrera from Spain, the taller of the two, tries to shoot underneath with the front leg, but it's Huang Xiangjiao. Both athletes just gasping in pain there. That looked like a sore one, a full contact martial art, of course. Armin Magablev from Australia, the centre referee, making sure that it's safe to continue. Fighters giving it plenty. Good attempted push kick to the body there. Well, a very good first round indeed. Jesus Tortosa Cabrera. He's up against it now. Zhang Yujin manages to score with a perfectly placed back kick. Of course, the local fans, there's a few taekwondo suits dotted in the crowd. Jesus Costa Cabrera is a world champion at the junior level. He's going to have to go some here. There's his friends and family. His father is the president of the Spanish Taekwondo Federation and himself a former world champion. Taekwondo obviously runs in that family. And they'll of course be cheering their son on. But this young man here, Huang Yujin. He's in good form and good position. The second round of the men's semi-final. 55 kilogram contest here. Spain in blue. Chinese Taipei in red. Good attempted head kick from Huang Juyen. Nice simple short kick on the inside from Huang. Using the front leg like a jab there. The Spanish fighter just trying to cut across the ring. Head kick from Huang. That's a great one in return for Huang Yujin. Pushes it upstairs. Takes a 6-point lead. Jesus Tortosa Cabrera tries to spin around, tries to take a head kick of his own. Going to have to produce something special here. Just over 30 seconds left in this second period. Produced some good work so far. Attempted back kick from Jesus Tortosa. Good flexibility on the way through there from Wang Yongju. Second round is in the books. A good one it was indeed for Chinese Taipei. Looking for more work after the first kick. We'll see President Thomas Bach enjoying the action, along with Dr. Chong Won Cho, the governing body president for Taekwondo. Trying to fight his way back into this, but he's struggling. Yang Fenyu making it very difficult for him. Stalemate now. Jesus Tortosa Cabrera cannot find his way through here. Huang Yufen. Nothing to choose between them now because Jesus Tortosa Cabrera cannot find a way through the redoubtable defence of Chang. He's too strong at the moment. It looks as if he's going to have to settle for a bronze. A low kick there. Just 30 seconds remaining now. Huang Yufeng doing well to cover the head kick attempt and moving back from the back kick from Jesus Tortosa Cabrera. The 20 seconds left in this pulsating contest. Who's going to make it into the final? A good head kick attempt. And we're going to have, of course, a video replay challenge for that. Mohamed Magbale of Australia going to explain, looking for a 3-point head kick. And the athlete in red, let's have a look. Just the front leg now, 1, 2, 3, anything? Park the tail. Nguyen Thao of Vietnam, the man in the front of your screen, he's going to decide. And Zhao, the Chinese Taipei coach, understands it. No, not successful. With 10 seconds from a spot in the final. Jesus Tortosa Cabrera trying to fight his way back into this. It looks like it's going to be bronze for the boys from Madrid. Nice sidestep. Wang Fengyao. Wonderful movement from him. Great speed. And it will be a bronze for Spain. Wang Yanfeo will have a chance to go for gold. Nice ovation from the local fans. Well, there's the tale for you. Wang Yufeng marches into the final. Jesus Tortosa, he takes bronze. Good power from the young Chinese Taipei fighter. Well, Tortosa Cabrera beaten. Yang Fu moves on. This is how and this is who. And it will be Ju Duhun of Korea against Huang Yu Fien of Chinese Taipei in the men's gold medal
boys
match.
And girls, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome athlete role model Wu Jinyu from China, 2006 Doha Asian Games champion, 2008 Beijing Olympic champion, and 2012 London Olympic champion. Today, she will share the joy and glory of Brisbane Taekwondo.
This, of course, Wu Jingyu, the double Olympic champion from 2008 in Beijing and indeed in London, a big hero here in China, an inspiration to many, an inspiration to the Chinese team and indeed to Indra Krayen from Belgium, who will go in the final in a few moments' time. So an international taekwondo ambassador, just obviously passing on her best regards to all the fans here. If you prefer your action a little bit more robust in forms of kicks and punches, just to let you know, in about 5 minutes' time, the finals will kick off. So do join us for that. Do stay with us, of course. If you want to take a little break, now would be a good time.
And
The final winning title of the 49th rank is going to start soon. Let's welcome the referee and judges.
青年朋友们，女士们，先生们。
Well, here we go with the gold medal match, the women's 49 kilogram category. Wang Qiuxian of Chinese Taipei. She will go against Belgium's Indra Krayen. Corner judges and referee assemble. This is the route to the final. Carillo Osorio settles for bronze, as does Yang Chan Ru of China. Mexico and China with the bronzes. Where will the gold and silver go? And the athletes are on their way in. The centre referee for the match will be the Segundo Flores of Mexico. Sadia Kala of Thailand. Jamaica's Mr. Conrad Jenkins. For the final, Eva Romanov of Croatia. Vietnam, Vu Jan Tan. We've seen the video review panel been very busy today. Will it be so for this 49 kilogram final? It's nice to see a very good ovation for the young Belgian. Last minute instructions for the battler from Brussels.
Come on, Indra.
Come on, Indra, indeed. Great young fighter, great opportunity, but great expectation and opposition for Wang Qiuxian. This is the gold medal match, the 49 kilogram final. From Chinese Taipei in blue, Wang Qiuxian. Indra Krayen from Belgium, she's in red. Straight into an open stance. Both have the same foot in front, which gives a big protectorate on the front side that leaves the main section of the body open. Ryan crying out, looks up for this. Wang in blue, crying in red. Footwork first from Wang. But crying pops a little shot under the guard. She overcame China to get to this final. Can she beat Chinese Taipei to grab the gold? Good head kick attempt from Krayen. She signals to her coach. Karim Degu from Belgium is looking for 3 points for the head kick. Have a look at that. You've seen it first. Make up your own minds at home.
Video replay.
Let's see what Wu Jiantan thinks. Nope. Unsuccessful. The card is gone. Could that prove costly? Still a good chunk of this final to go. Bang trying to be aggressive. Indra Krayan covering well. Put her hands up there. The athlete in red. She's full of confidence, the young Belgian. Finds his target. And again, with a push kick to the body. And Rafael slips to the mat. Flores gives it a Kyungo. A promising first round from Chinese Taipei's Wang Qianxiao. Here's the head kick. The 3 points go on the scoreboard. Just to decide who will be the Youth Olympic champion. Indra Krayan feeling the heat. So what a wonderful worker she is. With the second round of the female 49 kilogram gold medal contest, Wang Qianxiao. She's in blue from Chinese Taipei. Indra Krayan, she's in red from Belgium. And it's the young Belgian that's fighting hard. Produces a Kyungo. She's very aggressive, very tough. Indra Krayan from Belgium will not settle for anything less than gold. She's worked tremendously hard. Wang, very good defender of her lead, using the leg to block, using the hands to cover. Almost connecting to the head as well there, Yang. Great power from Indra Krayan. From Young, perfectly timed, perfectly placed, and again, that's a handy little leap. Trying 6 points behind, Wang looking good value for this lead here, just pushing the front leg out just to keep her opponent at bay. 20 seconds left in this second round. Will it be the Belgian who finds a scoring shot? Wang just keeping her at bay there, just with that push kick. Wonderful, powerful kick there. Attempted head kick from the young Belgian. Well, an engrossing second round. Wang Qianxiao. She looks to be in considerable pain and anguish. Stopping the blow, the fact that she's got 6 points to the good. Head kick.
vamos, verde en gran.
And the passionate Chinese Taipei contingent supporting their charge. They're looking for another goal for Chinese Taipei. Indra Kayan, the warrior that she is from Belgium. Brilliant young fighter. This is the third and final round of the female 49 kilogram gold medal contest. Which one of these women will be going home as the youth Olympic champion? At the moment it's Yang of Chinese Taipei. Manoeuvring well, staying in the blue section, doesn't want to stray into the red. Pia Kyungo if it happens. Yanshao has the advantage, has the skills. She's got her tactics spot on at the moment. No doubting the desire of the Belgian Kryan. But the athleticism of Wang just to stay in the ring. Doing tremendously well. She's earned this gold medal if she can seal it. She's got just over 30 seconds left of the third and final period to sustain it. Kryan almost scoring with the shot there. It will be a Kyungo. And indeed, a video replay. What drama here. Looking for 3 points for the head kick. Segundo Flores will go and discuss it now. This man here, Van Chantau. You can see the pain. What does it take to become the champion? It takes everything you've got. Out from Vietnam. Is this a gold medal deciding decision? It is indeed. Good work from Nang Xiao, the Chinese Taipei coach. 9-4 is good, but 12-4 is very, very good. Indra Kryan of Belgium. Well, she's fought hard all day. What a warrior she is. But it's going to be a super silver for her because Yang in control, looking strong. She's going to take a Kyungo for this one. Yang, the power player, is having to hang on to the bitter end. She's almost out into the stadium, sitting in the crowd, but 8 seconds left. She's going to have to dig deep and hang on. Indra Kryan, nothing but respect for her. Pure power, pure resilience, pure perseverance. But in the end, it's pure gold. Wang Yang Xiao. Olympic Games gold medalist 2014 49 kilogram champion. Wang Yang Xiao. My goodness, did she earn that? Indra Kryan, what a warrior, what a performer. Wang Jiao Tian. A lap of the mat. A glorious goal for her. If you need a little break from the action, I certainly do. The medal ceremonies are coming up, so hang around for that. And then we've got one more fantastic final for you, so do stay with us. The medal ceremonies on its way. course, the women's 49kg victory ceremony on its way. The destination of the medals already decided. The ladies just in the background getting ready for their moment in the spotlight. Richly deserved. Indra Krayen took a silver. Huang Kanxiao. She is the Youth Olympic champion. Bronze for Carillo Osorio of Mexico and Xian Tianru of China. We're here at the International Expo Arena, the Youth Olympic Games in Nanjing. Wonderful action all day. Enjoyed there by IOC President Thomas Bach. On his left, Dr. Chong Won Cho, the World Governing Body President for Taekwondo. Nice to see the IOC member for North Korea and for South Korea sitting together. Such is the power of sport, and what a sporting spectacle we have witnessed here tonight. The women's 49kg contest is already in the books, and we will have a chance to enjoy their medal ceremony along there with Jack Rogg, former IOC president, and all the assembled dignitaries, I'm sure, enjoying the fair here. Tremendous competition. The Youth Olympic Games, of course, with Jack Rogg's brainchild. It's been enjoyed, look at this, by all the youngsters. Lots of fun for all the family. And they've had some Chinese success as well, which is always nice. And indeed for Chinese Taipei, the local neighbours, they have a gold medal to celebrate. And athletes will be making their way in just a few seconds' time. The women's 49kg contest, well, it was tremendous. And don't panic, you've still got more Olympic taekwondo to enjoy. Look at the men's 55kg gold medal final. That will be contested between Korea and Chinese Taipei. The tremendous action still to behold. Lots of inspirational value for all the youngsters here. Well, they've queued up to get their tickets. They've taken the time to get here, and my goodness, they've certainly enjoyed it. Well, all countries mixing together, having a good time here in Nanjing. They've been fantastic hosts so far for this Youth Olympic Games. The fanfare signals the start of the ceremony. Hundreds and thousands of hours of practice and training, plenty of sacrifice and hard work has seen these fine fighting females make their way onto the podium. Fifty-eight nations have contested this Youth Olympic Games. We're going to have four of them represented here. Well, the minus 49kg contest What a battle it was all the way to the very end. Tremendous entertainment, great speed, great flexibility, but more important, great spirit. These young women have done themselves and their nations proud. Indra Crying of Belgium, so close to grabbing a gold. But Wang Yangxiao of Chinese Taipei, the better of the two. Zhang Ranchu of China on the right-hand side. Rio Oseldo of Mexico as well. Well, this is a wonderful moment for these young women. And the dignitaries assembled. Well, a special touch here for Taekwondo. Pierre Olivier, National Olympic Committee of Belgium, IOC member. He will present the medals. A good day for the Belgians, a busy day for the Belgians. And alongside him in red, double Olympic champion Wu Jingyu. She's from Beijing in China, just up the road. Long road, mind you. And of course, warm salutations from her, from the Nanjing faithful here. They've enjoyed all the Taekwondo. You have as well. There is more to come. The men's 55 kilogram gold medal final is on the way, but it is now about the ladies from Mexico. Maria Osorio, she's on the right hand side. And Zhang Rengqiu of China. Osorio Carillo of Mexico. Ozan Yantriao, so close in the quarter final. Osorio, great work for the young Mexican, a brilliant bronze for her. Jan, she would have had eyes on gold. Couldn't quite make it through though. I dare say we will see her again. Fantastic fighter. And this is her hero, the athlete role model, Wu Jingyu. Well, it's almost worth it not to get the gold. A nice hug from her hero. Doing well to contain her emotions, the youngster. Carillo Osorio. Now, you're not supposed to have a favourite as a commentator, you're supposed to be dispassionate and fair, and I was. But I have a sneaking favouritism here for Indra Crying. What a tremendous battle she put on today. She wasn't fancied to beat China, she did. She wasn't fancied to beat Mexico, she did. Tremendous battle all the way through. And Indra Crying representing the indomitable spirit of Taekwondo. And this is her hero as well, Wu Jingyu. How do you do, Wu Jingyu? Well, you do very well, Indra Crying. Silver medal. But there can only ever be one champion. All the effort's been put in. Huang Yangxiao from Chinese Taipei. She is the youth Olympic champion for 2014. Well, she said, "I'm winning smile all day." Let's enjoy her national anthem. Huang Xiaoxian, Youth Olympic Games champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the anthem of the Chinese Taipei Olympic Committee. 女士们、先生们，请起立，奏中华台北奥委会会歌。
Well, the Youth Olympic Games about solidarity, friendship and education and partnership, but more than that, it's about fighting for what you want, to inspire yourself to go beyond the levels, to reach for your dream and to grab the gold. Just the pure emotion there would have captured the hearts of anyone, regardless of sport or nation. Wang Yanxiao of Chinese Taipei. Tears of joy and pride. And a glorious gold medal for the youngster Indra Krayen. A brilliant silver medal. Mitzi Yemenya Carrillo Osorio. She goes back to Mexico with a bronze. And Chan Yan Rao of China. Not the medal she wanted, but a brilliant bronze nonetheless. Such youthful promise, such athletic prowess, such richly deserved medals for these young women. More action to come. The men's 55 kilogram gold medal final will follow in just a few moments' time. Let's hope for more of the same in terms of action and enjoyment. The men's 55-kilogram gold medal match. Yu Dong-hun from Korea. Hwang Yu-jin from Chinese Taipei. All the same looks, but who will be on top of the podium for the men? Will it be Du Young, who overcame Kepi of Belgium? Or Hwang, who bested Tortosa Cabrera from Spain? An all-Asian final. The referee in position, the judges ready to go. From Denmark, our centre referee, Mr. David Cooper. The judges from Puerto Rico, Isabel Tavares. From Morocco, Bernadi Tariq. And from Georgia, Maria Mercuri. The new replay duty, Vu Van Tan from Vietnam. These fans came to see the fighters. This young man, Yu Dong-hun, junior world bronze medalist. Can he be the youth Olympic champion? Or will it be the ever-smiling, fresh-faced Hwang Yu-jin? Could it be another gold for Chinese Taipei? David Cooper, the centre referee. This is the men's gold medal match in the 55-kilogram category class. In blue from Korea, Yu Dong-hun. Hwang Ju-yen from Chinese Taipei, he's in red. Hwang Yu-jin gets the first score on the board. Good turning kick to the body. Matched by Ju Dong-yeon from Korea. The sensors on the socks on the bottom of the feet of the athletes. And in the instep, you've got to contact with the body armor for it to be a point. It will score automatically. You can also kick to the face. 1 point for the body, 3 for the face. But if you spin before those kicks, you can double them up. There is a flicking head kick. Didn't quite score though. A good little first minute of this final here. Both fighters in an open stance, the same foot in front. Trying to draw the open side. The chest is open, but the back is covered. It's a very important technique to use if your opponent is good with the front leg. There's the front leg counter from Ju Dong-hun. Hwang Yu-fen tries to block as well. A pushing kick there, tries to slide in. Dong-hun trying to intimidate his opponent, trying to make him react.
This is the end of round one.
Well, a stalemate in the first period. Taipei City. 15 years old, the bottom end of the category. 17, Ju Dong-hun from Busan, the very south of Korea. The Korean coach. Advising the Korean fighter to throw the windball. Windball is left leg, throw the left leg turning kick.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go for the second round. This is the last match of the 55 kilogram contest. This one for the gold medal. Who will be the Olympic champion? Will it be Korea in blue? Will it be Chinese Taipei in red? This is the second round. The men's 55 kilogram final. Into the open stand straight away, both using the front leg to try and fence their way through. Well, you don't need me to explain how painful that can be. Just as well, he's wearing a groin guard. Huang Yujin in red. Zhu Dongyang, he's in blue, and it is Yujin that scores. Both fighters very tall indeed, 6'2". Korea's Zhu Dongyang, just a shade taller at 6 foot, or a shade smaller I should say, Huang Yujin. And that's important in terms of leg length, the battle. They're fencing with their feet, just pushing each other back. Just under 1 minute left in this second period. Who will make the commitment to try and go to the head? Huang Yujin almost. Fighter from Chinese Taipei in red, Korea in blue. And it is the Korean who pops one into the chest and makes it 2 points apiece. Second period, and it is Chinese Taipei's Huang Yujin who finds the score. That makes the trip back to your coach a little bit better. A nice shot of the sensor sock there. That's the one that has to hit off the body armor. The points to register. He's going for gold, but coming across the ring, Zhu Dongyang from Korea. The Korean in blue, Chinese Taipei in red. This is the third and final round of the men's gold medal contest here at the Youth Olympic Games. Straight away, Yang Yujin just on the scoreboard. This is much more like it from these two men here, battling it out, pushing for the title of Youth Olympic Champion. Huang Yujin has a 4-point lead. Let's see the skills now of Zhu Dongyang. He's going to have to do something to produce a moment of magic. Good attempted head kick from the Korean. Just sails over the shoulder. Huang Yujin. Good shot underneath the guard there of Dongyang of Korea. Almost scoring. Well blocked though. Well, we're into the final minute now. Who will be crowned the Youth Olympic Games champion? Into the open stance. Just trying to draw each other forward. Zhu Dongyang has to try and produce something. He has to go on the attack. The Korean is 4 points down. Can he find an answer? Or will it be Yang Yujin of Chinese Taipei? Yang Yujin looking strong. trying to keep his opponent at bay. Good defence. They're fighting to the ends of their energy. Who will be able to produce the scoring shot here? There's a wonderful head kick. Wang Yujin almost scoring there. Takes the Kyungo. Doesn't affect the score. Still just over 20 seconds left in a fantastic final here. Good attempted head kick from the Korean Yong Hu Young, but it is another point for Chinese Taipei's Wang Ju Yin. He's got 10 seconds left to hang on here. Good power punch from Chinese Taipei. With just 5 seconds left, will he have enough energy and strength to keep the Korean at bay? Wang Yujin. He is the youth Olympic champion. And my goodness, he earned that one. He fought to the very end. Ju Dong-hyun of South Korea takes silver, but it's this young man here, Wang Yujin. He is the youth Olympic champion. Nice embrace from both fighters. But a wonderful moment for this young man. Tremendous etiquette, tremendous respect all day. And this is a lovely moment for him. Well, I hope they've got more than one flag, the Chinese Taipei delegation. Double gold, 49 kilo and 55 kilo, women and men respectively. Well, here's the result. Ju Do-young takes silver. Wang Yujin grabs the gold. Gold for Taipei, silver for Korea. What a match. Understandably, the men have just finished fighting, so they're going to have to get changed, get the national team tracksuits on, and then they will have a chance to get on to the podium. And the men on top of the podium, they're both on your screen just now. The man in blue, Ju Do-young, takes a silver. Wang Yujin, he is the champion. You really need these slow motions to see the head kicks, the flexibility. Brilliant win for that young man. So the medal ceremony to follow in just a few moments. Do stay with us for that one. Well, if you have any energy left in your body after watching the taekwondo, save it for the men's 55 kilogram victory ceremony. It's been a tremendous day of action. And these young men have earned their medals and then some. This was the pathway to the gold medal, Mohamed Kepi of Belgium. He's going to take a bronze medal, Ju Do Young from South Korea. Well, almost getting the gold. Hwang Yang Seo, he is the champion. Jesus Tortosa Cabrera has to set up a silver. This is the medal ceremony time. These young men have worked long and hard for this moment in the spotlight. And it's a genuine privilege to be able to share it with them. If you've ever done sport to any level, you know how hard it is. If you've ever done taekwondo, you know that it can be doubly difficult in the mind and body. But these young men, fine ambassadors for their country, for their families, and of course for the sport of taekwondo. Four good men and true, but only one champion. And it's been a great day for Chinese Taipei. Double gold celebrations. Special moments celebrated with the world governing body president, Dr. Chung Won Cho. Mr. Smelly Almahada, the IOC member from Syria. And Dr. Chung Won Cho, World Governing Body President, on the right of your screen. Well, special moments for these young men. The junior world champion, Jesus Tortosa Cabrera, would have come here looking for gold, but he manages a smile. He knows that a brilliant bronze in years to come takes special pride of place. Mohamed Kepi of Belgium and Jesus Tortosa Cabrera of Spain, the bronze medalists. Nanjing Lele, the official mascot. dancing at a stadium near you. Lulu, that is. Belgian bronze to add to the Belgian silver from Indra Krayen, but he's a Tortosa. Cabrera. Great bronze medal for him as well. Ju Jong Hun, the big man from Korea. The mascot. Undoubtedly delighted to have former IOC president Jack Grogg and current president Thomas Bach in attendance. He enjoyed it. Ju Dong Hun certainly did. He's gone home with a super silver. Could have been gold. But it can only ever be one top man from Chinese Taipei. He is your Youth Olympic Games champion. He fought with great power and strength all day, great composure, and it's a great gold medal for Wang Yujian of Chinese Taipei. The baby-faced assassin, wonderful fighter, wonderful spirit, wonderful smile from him as well. And we know that the DJ has the Chinese national anthem, so let's enjoy now Wang Yujin from Chinese Taipei. This is the national anthem of Chinese Taipei.
Ladies and gentlemen, we stand for the anthem of the Chinese Taipei Olympic Committee. 女士们、先生们，请起立，奏中华台北奥运会会歌。
Lovely scenes for the medalists. Tremendous souvenirs for them from the Youth Olympic Games here in Nanjing.
The Youth Olympic Games medalist!
Wang Yujin, he is the champion. Top of the podium. Will he invite his fellow fighters up to join him on the top step? He has indeed. Wang Yujin grabs gold. Korea's Ju Dong Hyun. Mohamed Kepi takes bronze. Jesus Tortosa Cabrera, another bronze. But it is the champion Wang Yujin of Chinese Taipei. Richly deserved. Fantastic medals, fantastic moments